Hello and welcome to 10 for Tech, where we take up to 10 minutes to dive into bite-sized portions of technology. Today, we want to talk about a new feature that was recently added in Office 365 to Microsoft Streams. Now you can capture up to 15 minutes worth of screen recording video, load it to your channel, and share it out with your students in a matter of minutes. So let's take a look and I'll show you how to get it done. First of all, we want to log in to Office 365, and we could do that from the UNCP homepage. Let's go over to Quick Links, and we're going to scroll down on the right here to Office 365. Now, once we get into our Office 365 homepage, we want to look for Microsoft Stream. If for some reason Microsoft Stream is not in your list of apps here, just go over to all apps and you'll find it there. Right here is Microsoft Stream. If you're not familiar with Microsoft Stream, I would invite you to check out our previous video on introduction to Microsoft Stream so you can get the gist of how everything works. But since most of you already know about Stream, we're going to get right to the cut and show you how to get going on your video. So once I get on my Microsoft Stream landing page, I want to go to Create. And I'm going to hit the down arrow there and I want to go to Record Screen. Now I get a few options here from my browser asking me to allow use of the microphone and the camera. And I want to hit Allow. And then we get a couple messages here. Now, depending upon what browser you're using is dependent upon the way the message appears to you. I'm using Google Chrome, so this is how it's gonna look on Chrome. Now, I get this pop-up screen here saying record your screen, and I have a couple of options. Now, if you look over here to the left, I have a microphone, a webcam option here, and where I can select my particular webcam. And I have a microphone option if I have multiple microphones connected to my device. But if you only have one, it should default to the one that you have. And I'm going to select here, this webcam here. And what it's going to do is going to put my video from my webcam in a picture-in-picture and capture my screen with a picture-in-picture of my video down in the right corner. So to begin recording, we want to hit the large start recording button. Now, when I hit record, a couple of things happen. As you see, it put my video from my webcam over in the bottom right corner here, and another pop-up screen comes up and gives me a few options. Now, I have the option to record my entire screen or a particular application window. If I were to have PowerPoint open or Excel, I could choose to record just that screen, or I could choose to record a tab in Google Chrome or the browser that I'm using. So right for this application, we're just going to record our full screen here. We're going to hit share. And then I get a countdown. And bam, now we are recording. And see, now that we're recording, I'm going to go back to my PowerPoint. I'm going to go in presentation mode. And we're going to go through these slides just like we would in our class or whatever we're trying to do. Now, I'm done recording, and I want to hit stop. I'm going to hit the pause button here. And then what we're going to do, we're going to go next. And then I have an option to, I can play the video here, I can preview it, or I can record it again if I didn't like what I did, or we can upload it to Stream. Now, on this next tab, I can give it a name, I can give it a description. I can set the video language for this, and this is going to help with my transcriptions. And then I want to leave this check to allow everyone in the company to view this video, unless we have a special group that we are assigning it to. But normally we're just going to leave this check and then we're going to hit publish. And now I want to go to video so I can do some further stuff on my video. So now that my video is finished processing, I did an action that I actually did not record. I want to see if I can go back to it. And I trimmed my video because I wanted it to start right at the moment where I started my PowerPoint. So to do that, you're going to go to, on your video page here, you want to go to more actions, the three dots, and hit trim video. All right. And then you want to drag at the front and at the end of your video timeline here. You have some handles and you can drag that left and right around to the point where you want to start. So I'm going to tighten it up just a tad bit. And I want to stop my video. I want my video to end before I get out of presentation mode. And then when I'm done, I want to hit apply. Save changes, continue. Now look, don't worry. When you get to this next screen, your video probably won't be trimmed. In fact, you're going to get an alert in the upper left corner that says, hey, your video is being trimmed and will be updated soon. Try refreshing the page. So it took me a couple of minutes before my video was trimmed. And to see that video, what I had to do was refresh the page. And eventually this alert message went away and my video popped up. So let's wait for that now. Okay, so now my video is trimmed. Now there's a couple things I could do. If I want to share this out with my students, I'll just hit the share button here. Again, I have another option where I could tell it to start. I want it to start playing at a certain time, or I can get a direct link to this video, or I could email it here within Microsoft Stream if I desire. I can get an embed link or embed code, excuse me, that I could copy and place into my Canvas course, or I could take this link to the video and place it in an email to all of my students, or I can place this in a Canvas course as well. Next, I want to show you how to quickly add captions to your video and edit them to make sure they're correct. So again, I want to go to More Actions. I want to go to Update Video Details. And while I'm here, if I need to update the name or the description, I could do all of that as well. But what I have to do first, pay attention here. You have to go to Video Language and select the language that you want your captions to be in, your transcripts. So we're going to go there. And then once I do that, that gives me an auto-generate a caption file. So what that's going to do is going to listen to my video and auto caption that file for me. Then once I do that, I want to hit apply. Now that you selected the auto generate a caption file, please know it's not going to be instant. It is going to take a few minutes for that file to process. So I say have a little patience, go get a cup of coffee, chill out, and then come back, refresh the page and see if your captions are there. Since that video is still processing the transcript, we're going to bring up another video and show you how to edit those captions. So here's the video that I want to edit the captions for. And if I go over here to the right-hand side, I have my transcript window. So all I have to do is play the video and scan through the text. And if I see something that's not quite correct, I could just click on the pencil icon here and just type in the corrections that I need. And then once I'm done, I just hit save. And that's it. That's as simple as it is for editing your captions. Now, once you're done, you can go back and share this video with your students through the ways that we talked about earlier. And that's just about it for today's session. If you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact the help desk and we'll get you the information that you need. And thank you so much for joining us for 10 for Tech. And remember, it's really not that hard.